okay? Who he is, and we'll see the answer coming out, okay?
From the gospel of Mark.
Jesus and his disciples left the village around Caesarea Philippi. On the way, Jesus put this question to his disciples: who do the people say that I am? And they said to him, some say you're John the Baptist, others said Elijah, others again, one of the prophets. And Jesus said, but you, who do you say that I am? They're all quiet. And Jesus spoke up and said, you are the Christ. And he gave them strict orders not to tell anyone about this. And Jesus began to teach them that the Son of Man was destined to suffer grievously, to be rejected by the elders and the chief priests and the scribes, and be put to death. And after 3 days, rise again. And he said all this quite openly. Then, taking him aside, Peter started to question Jesus and fight, but turning and seeing his disciples, he said, you cannot do this. And Jesus, but turning and seeing his disciples, Jesus rebuked Peter and said to him, get behind me, Satan, because the way you think is not God's way, but man. Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Jesus lived 33 years. The first 30 years, we call his the quiet part, right? You know, basically, they just know what, oh, this is Joseph's son, the carpenter, and he had a very quiet life in Nazareth. But now, 3 years, he is what they call his public ministry. And what does he do? He raises the dead, the blind see, the deaf hear, the dumb speak, the cripples walk, lepers are healed. He feeds 5,000 people at the same time with a couple of loaves of bread, right? And that's why Jesus asked his disciples, who do people say I am? So they know he's a prophet, right? Prophet is one who speaks for God. And then old Peter, filled with the Spirit, says, you're the Messiah. Now, what was the Messiah to the Jews? They were waiting. Now, here they were captured by Rome. They were basically slaves to Rome. And under King David, they had it made. Peace, prosperity, everything was good. But they knew this Messiah, whenever he came, would be from King David, and so probably be the same thing. But now when Peter says, you're the Messiah, they're thinking, we have our king, he'll destroy Rome, everything will be peace and decree again. But what did Jesus say? No, the Son of Man, the Messiah, will suffer on the cross, but will die. Be rejected by all the religious leaders and all the people in power, right? Totally rejected, right? And then Peter saying, no way you should do this, you know. And then Jesus calls him, get behind me, Satan. Now, why does he say that? Because now this is a temptation, right? The devil attacks us. And they are disciples. We follow the leader, right? We don't lead the leader. We follow the leader. That's why you're called a disciple. It's a discipline. You follow what they teach you. And so Jesus tells him, get behind me. And so each one of us, that's why Jesus said, all of us will have to carry our cross. That's part of being a Christian. Because where is Jesus' kingdom? Not in this world, it is in heaven, right? And if Jesus, our Savior, will carry the cross, that's a symbol to each one of us, the same thing will happen to us, all right? But what we say, my yoke is easy, my burden is much easier. All of us have our problems, but with Jesus, things become that much easier. Faith in Jesus, always think for the best. Let's pray for all our sins.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, grace, the Lord is with thee, blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, especially those most needy in mercy. To these gifts which we are about to receive from thy bounty through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Oh, Jesus,
oh, how I love you. us, because he first loved us.